गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट सेंटेंसेस, फ्रेजेस, सब्जेक्ट एंड प्रेडिकेट ऑफ क्लास सिक्स इंग्लिश ग्रामर चैप्टर वन। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू नो व्हाट इज सेंटेंस। अ सेंटेंस इज अ ग्रुप ऑफ वर्ड्स व्हिच मेक्स कंप्लीट सेंटेंस। सो सेंटेंस इज अ ग्रुप ऑफ वर्ड्स एंड इट मेक्स अ कंप्लीट सेंस। इफ इट डजंट मेक अ कंप्लीट सेंस, इट इज नॉट अ सेंटेंस। हियर एग्जाम्पल इज गिवेन। सो फर्स्ट एग्जाम्पल इज द गर्ल इज रीडिंग, मीन्स इन अ सेंटेंस दिस इज द ग्रुप ऑफ वर्ड द गर्ल इज रीडिंग। दिस सेंटेंस हैज फोर वर्ड्स एंड इट गिव्स अ कंप्लीट सेंस, दैट्स वाई इट इज अ सेंटेंस। एंड सेकेंड सेंटेंस look at my kite, it the second sentence also gives a complete meaning, that's why it is also a sentence. But if it doesn't give complete meaning, that is not a sentence. So third is, why are you standing here, that is interrogative sentence, but it is also a sentence. Now coming the phrase. What is phrase? Phrase, it doesn't have a subject and predicate. As you can see here, a phrase is a group of words that stands together as a single unit, typically as a part of sentence. Actually, it stands together as a single unit in a sentence, and it is a part of sentence. That is not a complete sentence, but it is a part of sentence. So here you can see the example of phrase. So my friend Rama, it doesn't give, this sentence doesn't give the complete meaning, that's why it is not a sentence, but it is a phrase. Behind the door, that is also a phrase. Barking dogs, because it doesn't have the subject and predicate, so the phrase or the sentence which doesn't have the subject and predicate, that is not a sentence, that is a phrase. So in these sentences there is no subject, that's why it is not a, that is not a phrase. And my friend Rama, behind the door, barking dogs, in these sentences are not a full sentence, complete sentence, because it doesn't give these don't give the complete meaning, that's why these are not sentence, these are phrases. Subject and predicate. As you can see here, what is subject and what is predicate in a sentence. So here subject is that part of a sentence, that the subject is that part of a sentence about which something is said, means subject is that part of a sentence that which about which something is said, means the predicate is saying something about the subject, that part is called the subject. And what is predicate here? What is said about the subject is called the predicate, means what is said about the subject, that is predicate, means what is said about the subject, means that predicate is saying about the subject, means which part is saying about the subject, that part is the predicate. Here you can see what is the subject and what is predicate, means in a sentence which part is the subject and which part is the predicate. So bird fly, bird is a subject and fly is the predicate. Bird the subject and fly is the predicate. Cows eat grass, cow is the subject, and after the verb other part of the sentence, that is the predicate. The horse is white, here the horse is the subject, and after the verb the other part of the sentence, that is the predicate. Means you have to find out, first of all you have to find out where is the verb or the helping verb. After the helping verb, the other part of the sentence is called predicate of the sentence. Old mother Howard went to the cupboard. So old mother Howard is a subject and went is here verb, and after went the other part of the sentence is called predicate of the sentence. Dear students, as you can see here, exercise 1 of chapter 1, my friend Rama. In these sentences, you have to find out the sentence and the phrase, and which is phrase and which is sentence. In front of the sentence, you have to write yes, and just before the phrase, you have to write F. So here, you find out which is the sentence and which is phrase. My friend Rama, as I told you, the phrase is that which has no subject and predicate of its own, that is a phrase. And means the sentence has the subject and the verb of its own, or the subject and the predicate of its own, that is the sentence. So in this first sentence, my friend Rama, there is no verb, and that's why it has no predicate. So that is the phrase. In the second sentence, the wind is cold. It has the subject of its own and the predicate of its own. So that is the sentence. Barking dogs. It has no subject and predicate of its own. That's why it is a phrase. So she is a good girl. It has the subject of its own, she, and verb is, and predicate a good girl. So this is the subject sentence. Behind the door. In this sentence, it has no subject and predicate of its own. So that's why it is a phrase. Birds fly. In this sentence, it has its own subject and verb. So bird is the subject and fly is the verb. And it gives the complete meaning. That's why it is a sentence. The express bus. So in this sentence, it has no subject or predicate of its own. That's why it is a phrase. On the desk. In this sentence also, it has no subject of its own, so it is also a phrase. Fire burns. It gives the sentence fire burns gives complete sense. Here the fire is the subject and burn is the main verb, and it gives the complete meaning. That's why it is a sentence. My sister and my brother. In this sentence, it has no verb and predicate of its own. That's why it is not a sentence. That is a phrase. In the 11th sentence, in the bridge. In this sentence, it doesn't have its own subject and predicate of its own. That's why it is also a phrase. And the phone rang. In this sentence, that is the last 12th sentence. In this sentence, the subject and the verb have of its own. So the phone is the subject and rang is the verb, and it gives complete meaning. That's why it is a sentence. Dear students, you can see here exercise 2. In exercise 2, you have to separate the subject and the predicate. So first of all, sentence number 1, sentence, the carriage is at the door. So which part is the subject and which part is the predicate of this sentence? So before the verb or the helping verb, that is the subject एंड अदर पार्ट ऑफ द सेंटेंस इज द प्रेडिकेट. इन सेकेंड सेंटेंस लंडन इज ऑन द टेंस. सो लंडन इज, सो इज इज द हेल्पिंग वर्ब हियर, मेन वर्ब. सो लंडन इज द सब्जेक्ट एंड अदर पार्ट ऑफ द सेंटेंस इज द प्रेडिकेट. अब्दुल हैज गॉन. सो इन दिस सेंटेंस अब्दुल इज द सब्जेक्ट एंड हैज गॉन इज द प्रेडिकेट. इन द फोर्थ सेंटेंस रामा वॉज पनिश्ड. सो रामा इज द सब्जेक्ट एंड वॉज आफ्टर द वर्ब अदर पार्ट ऑफ द सेंटेंस, दैट इज द प्रेडिकेट. इन सेंटेंस नंबर फिफ्थ सम बैड बॉयज स्मोक सिगरेट्स. सो सम बैड बॉयज, हियर द वर्ब इज द स्मोक, मीन्स आफ्टर द आफ्टर स्मोक मीन्स आफ्टर वर्ब दैट अदर पार्ट ऑफ द सेंटेंस द प्रेडिकेट एंड बिफोर वर्ब दैट इज द सब्जेक्ट. ही गोज टू चर्च ऑन संडेज. सो ही गोज, हियर द वर्ब इज गोज, आफ्टर द वर्ब अदर पार्ट ऑफ द सेंटेंस द प्रेडिकेट एंड ही इज द सब्जेक्ट हियर. एंड द विलेज मास्टर टॉट हिज लिटिल स्कूल. सो द विलेज मास्टर टॉट, हियर द वर्ब इज टॉट, आफ्टर वर्ब दैट इज अदर पार्ट ऑफ द सेंटेंस द प्रेडिकेट एंड बिफोर द वर्ब दैट इज द सब्जेक्ट. अ बार्किंग साउंड द शेफर्ड हियर्स. सो अ बार्किंग साउंड द शेफर्ड हियर्स means here in this sentence the verb is here. So before that verb the that part of the sentence the subject and other part of the predicate. In ninth sentence into the street the piper stepped. Like above sentence before the verb the part that part of the sentence is the subject and other part of the sentence the predicate. My new watch keeps good time. So here the verb is keeps, often keeps, that is the predicate, and before part of the sentence the subject. As you can see the exercise here, in this exercise in all the sentences you have put the appropriate subject. So dash is sweet, or in this sentence you can fill any subject but the subject should be singular. According to sentence, sugar is sweet, the girl is sweet, so she is sweet, like that you can feel here. Sugar is sweet. Dash caught a mouse. So who caught the mouse here? Cat caught a mouse. You can feel cat. Cat caught a mouse. This is the past indefinite sentence. Third, Dash has three windows. So in a room there are many windows. So what should be there? Window, room. A room has three windows. So what is the subject here? A room. Dash love little pussy. So who love? Generally I love my little pussy. You can feel here like that. So I love my, so that is the subject. I love my I love little pussy. So what is the subject here? I. In the fifth sentence, dash like milk. Cat like, cats like milk. Dash build nest. Birds build nest. One more thing you have to keep in your mind. What is that the singular subject is there or the plural subject is there? According to the means plural verb is there or the singular verb is there. So according to the verb, you have to put the subject. If your subject is singular, you have to put the subject. If your verb is singular, you have to put the subject singular. If your verb is plural, you have to put the verb plural, subject plural. So here the verb is plural, build. So you have to put here the subject plural. And dash is crowing. Who is crowing? A rooster is crowing or a cock is crowing. So a rooster is crowing. How well dash sings? how well she sings. Here the subject verb is singular, that's why we applied here the subject singular. So in the ninth sentence, dash is ringing the bell or the my phone, like that you can fill the subject. So my phone is ringing. In the last 10th sentence, once upon a time there lived. So what is lived is the verb here. After you have to fill the predicate. There lived a man. Thank you, students.